doing something for a bit of fun today, which is a narrow-necked vase, which I haven't tried for a little while, and I don't think I've ever tried in this clay, which is the PF580, slightly more porcelain. I feel it throws more like porcelain than the other clays that I'm used to. So I'm not sure how well I'll be able to do this, but it's always a fun challenge. This is one of the pieces that having a heat gun or a blowtorch is really useful for, because what you want to do is throw the bottom half, kind of two thirds, and then get it firm enough that you can really push the clay at the top without ruining what you've done at the bottom. So this is about 500 grams. What I'm going to do is leave a blob of clay at the top, and I want to get the bottom fairly bulbous before I start on the top part. Happy with that as a starting point. What do you clean my hands off and then get this much, much firmer before I do anything else. So now I'm essentially throwing onto, try and avoid using too much water. I've basically firmed up the base. It's like you've set, almost like you set the bat height higher. So it's almost like you're throwing from a bat here, because the bottom is now solid. Obviously it's not exactly like that, but you know what I mean, in that you can push this clay a lot more than you would be able to if the clay beneath it was still entirely soft. What I don't want to do is get the plate too wet. I've already put too much water, and more water than I intended on the inside. I've got to get that out before I seal it up any further. Telescopic zeam. Yeah, I definitely don't need it to be as long as it is. Quite neat. Okay, so now colouring in. So what I'm doing is each time I colour in, the clay gets thicker because you're taking the same amount of clay and reducing the diameter. And then you can use the spare clay to pull up for more height. The difficulty being not opening it too much back out each time you pull up the height. If you're not careful, you end up going basically just retreading the same ground, colouring in, opening out, colouring in, and not really gaining anything. So what you want to do is each time you repeat the steps, you want to get more height and less width. I am getting there. Once you get down, I mean, I say all of this like I know what I'm talking about. I really don't. There are some fantastic potters, Matt Horn being the one that I always go to for stuff like this, but there are plenty of amazing potters making really precise, giant pieces with very narrow necks. And I'm not one of them, but something I found for bringing the neck up and really closing it down is when you can't get a finger inside, you can switch hands. You use a smooth handled metal tool like this. You can bring the neck up. I would ideally like to get it a little bit taller than that. I think as a first practice piece, I'm going to call that finished. And then I will use the needle tool once it's dried up a bit tomorrow to chop the top level. You try and do it now, I've found it never ends well. The clay of the neck is far too delicate to take that without knocking it off centre. And then there's a tiny bit of extra clay at the base, which can be trimmed off now or get rid of more tomorrow to make it that bit more bulbous. Yeah, that works. Better than I was expecting for a first attempt at least.